Welcome to our essay series. This is second essay in this series, that is, we are discussing about essays given in UPSC Civil Services Mains Examination 2019. So there, from section A, second essay, I am discussing values are not what humanity is, but what humanity ought to be. मूल्य वे नहीं जो मानवता है बल्कि वे है जैसा मानवता को होना चाहिए. Let us take first part. Values are not what humanity is. That first part we have to discuss first, and then we are going to discuss second part, that is, but what humanity ought to be, जैसा मानवता को होना चाहिए. So we are going to discuss that. So first thing, that what we can consider as human values. Prior to that, how we can distinguish between other animals and man. Obviously, this is not topic of biology, but when we are talking of psychology, when we are talking about various parts in literature, we have to distinguish between man and other animal. Many times we are using word that behave like human, don't behave like animal. But the fact is that many times animals behave with more human values. And then again question is there, what is human value? Getting idea? And so this is also a sort, we can say, a bit difficult to explain the topic, but it's nice thing that you can discuss with your knowledge of psychology, with your knowledge of biology, with your knowledge of political science, and with knowledge of history, you can discuss. Now, obviously, I have to give introduction. So, in that introduction para, within 30 words, we have to write. So, what we can give here, justification. The thing is that human beings are considering themselves as something separate from all rest of the animal kingdom because they have power of thinking, they have ability to speech, and they are able to present their emotions more than what other animals can show. I'm not saying other animals are not at all showing emotions. They are also showing emotion, but the range of emotions shown by human being, they are more wide as compared to all other animals are showing. And therefore, human values, we are considering something as separate. First, we are focusing on that human values, and then we are taking another part, but what we consider human values. So values are not what humanity is, but humanity ought to be. So that we have to explain. So what we are defining here, the humanity. So here we are defining humanity in the way that in given circumstances, how human should behave. That indicate the humanity values. There we have to point out that what values are there. If you are following values, then you are human being. No. You are human being there, you have to follow that value automatically. That we have to give intro. Within 30 words, we have to give intro. And then onwards, we will start describing one by one. So first, I must describe here. It is a bit a spiritual topic, we can say. Many of those who are studying about biology deeply, may possible, they may not like what I am speaking here. Because many times we discuss that biology is not expecting the presence of God or the spirituality aspect. But yet, certain questions are there. I can define this way, that those, you can, if you believe in God, you can call him God or creator if you are not believing. Those who created us, this is well-programmed body. Entire universe is well-programmed body. And they have produced out machines. In simple language, I am explaining those who are creators or the one who is creator, or one leader and their associates, whatever that you can consider. But the creators, or if you are believing in that system of God, then God created this way, that certain programs are fixed, certain laws are fixed, and according to that, they have created this all thing. Let me clarify. If you observe a cow, it's obvious food. We can say that cow is grazing animal. So grass or whatever the plants are there, basically grass family, that is cereal category plants, then various leaves, all these part, that is food of that cow. Who suggested cow that you have to eat that? It is default. Okay. It is not the thing happen that cow is hungry and therefore obviously not a domestic, it in jungle, suppose cow is hungry, that is planning that I must hunt something and eat that. So it is not happening. It is not that cow is going to eat something which is not its part of food. No. They have definite program. This is your food, that is fitted in their mind. That program works according to time. That's why various actions, rather we are saying instinct, they are there in animals. So many animals, in case of many animals, particularly mammals, they are having instinct that they can feed their offsprings, or they are going to take care of their offsprings. Say for example, cat. So female cat, in earlier stages of their kitten, they are taking care. Literally for around 2.5 month age, till that kittens are being fed up by that cat. But after that, that cat wants that, wants cat, no. Actually the programmer wants that kitten should now get separate from that cat. And for that purpose, she is there with kitten, but don't allow to drink milk. Instead of that, she tries that kitten should go for hunting. She offer them some sort of food, especially hunting, usually rats, they are offered. It is given. So like that, some training is also provided, and henceforth that cat will consider that kitten, grown up obviously, as their competitors. Alright, so this is all they have behaved according to the program written for them. The next generation of cat will do again same thing. Similar thing you can observe in case of lions. They have also a well-defined program. But what is basic difference between tigers and lions? That lions usually want to stay in a community, in a group. Whereas tigers don't want to stay in community usually. They want to stay isolated form. And this way, every animal is working according to their program given by a creator or God. They are working. And now the values are there. Say for example, in case of, you can observe YouTube, various hunting scenes are there. So, this feline category animal, for example, cheetah, the mother cheetah is going to catch usually infant, deer or like that grazing animal. It will not kill, but little bit injured, and then that will be given to their offsprings. Why? So they will carry out practice of hunting over that animal. In all this scenario, what the small grazing animal is suffering, that is not at all taken into consideration. They are only thinking that it is experimented for other cheetah, that they should learn the art of hunting, and next they can use that art hunting skill, and other animals, they will be killed with more sophisticated manner for that purpose. So here there are no grievances for that cheetah or that whatever that smaller cheetah or whatever that animal is. I am taking example of cheetah, but everywhere these words, and therefore you can consider their values, they are working according to the instinct. I should not say the behavior is inhuman behavior. If you observe wild dogs, the horse of wild dog, usually they eat prey alive. And then you can observe that hunting also, it is not that good to observe, but prey is alive and that is hunted by these wild dogs, or even hyenas, if you are aware, they are also doing the same thing. Various time you can observe that various birds, they are eating out fish with more brutal manner. The death is not easy for these fish. But yeah, we have to say that is not human value. Again and again I am pointing out a word. What is human value? See, these birds, they can't think like that. Certain videos are there that certain animals are thinking. Especially, sometime it happens. Not always. But otherwise you can check that these animals, they have a definite pattern of behavior. Even in case of human being, we are also following a definite pattern. We are guided. Say for example, if you are aware that after the birth of child, the first important task that child should do, that is the crying action. Then only the respiration can start. So this is important, but who is going to teach that? So this is inbuilt program. The movement of hands, legs, that is also inbuilt program. So all these human beings, when they come into the world, they are having ability to move their hands, legs, but they are not able to walk. How you can distinguish between other animals and human being is that human being, they have prolonged childhood. Just now I was telling about that, about kitten. So around 2.5 month kitten, then that can be becoming a sort, we can say, little bit independent. And after that, it is considered as independent when it reaches to around age of 3.5 months. After that, it is considered as independent, not matured. Around 1 year, it getting completely matured. Average life of cat is around 10 to 15 years, if it is living peacefully and dogs and other accidents were not there. Then that cat can live in the range of 10 to 15 years. Let us imagine 10 years that cat is living. That means childhood period is of 1 year. And then whatever the childhood period, 10 times of that, their total life is there. In case of human being, we consider that maturity is attained around 18 years old. If that is the situation, then 18 multiplied by 10, 180 years should be our average life. Forget of 180. If you are reaching to 80, then also all right. So this is the difference. That's why we are saying, usually, in case of human being, childhood is prolonged part. And now we have to think that why childhood is prolonged? Obviously, to learn many things. So, what is difference between other animal and man? That other animals are going purely by their instinct and they learn little bit technique. Say for example, the techniques, they are necessary for survival. For example, hunting, etc. for predators. Like that techniques, they are required. Even you observe nest built up by birds. They are not a piece of intelligence of that bird. It is piece of intelligence of the creator of that bird. Okay, and that's why you'll find the beaver bird that will construct house, that nest. That pattern is same everywhere. They will not think that, okay, let us construct nest in some different form. Why only a definite bottle type format, inverted bottle type format, we will construct in reverse way? No, they will go indefinite pattern. That's why we are saying that birds, other animals, they are going by their natural instinct. And little bit education is required for them. which is given by their community or by that particularly mother and in some time father, sometimes. But in case of human being, we require a lot of education. We are going with our instinct as well as what we acquired. So that is the major difference. Now, certain things we are going to acquire as we are living in the society. And then we are having impact of the values given by society. That way we are going to reflect. Say for example, if you observe in some parts of India, there are people, those who are celebrating out their marriages to very great extent. But what is that great extent? Usually we are bringing out huge loudspeakers. That person is having 10 speakers. Okay, I will put 15 speakers, woofer and all that, and make loud noise. That means marriage is greater. So like that, if one person is doing that, another will go to do that. Third person will say that, all right, I am observing both of these fellow, they use this type of speakers. I will use even some new system of speaker, DJ and something like that for that. And this way, community is having impact on us. That determines our values. So we are basically trained by our natural instinct, plus whatever the things we are learning at our home, plus whatever the community is teaching you. Three, plus. Now this plus is important. This is your own thinking ability. That you have to add. Say, if one person is using 10 speakers in his marriage, second person is using 15 speakers in marriage, then third person should think that, okay, by 10 speakers at a time, so many people around that territory troubled out because of noise pollution. With 15 speakers, larger area was troubled. Why, at my pleasure, I should trouble other people? And third person should say, or using his own intelligence at that time, that person should say, yes, at time of my marriage, I will not torture anybody. I will celebrate, but without torturing, without troubling to other people. I want to enjoy, but not at cost of others' curse. Okay, so this is something thinking ability we have. If you observe, the animals are killed brutally by other animals, particularly predators. But being human, you can do one more thing, that you can kill these animals, if at all required, with more simplified way or more easy way. Say for example, it is sometimes happening that certain tigers or leopards, they are overnumbered, or sometimes they turn to man-eater. And at that time, as there is no alternative, then government decides that, all right, we have to kill them. Now, why to shoot them with bullets? Instead of that, we can give some tranquilizers and then kill them if at all required. Otherwise, why to kill? By using tranquilizers, you can keep them into the cage and we can give them food, which is obviously not human being. So like that, we can do for these animals also. This is something we are calling as human value. So we have thinking ability, and by using that thinking ability, we can say at least that we should not torture others. We should not trouble others. So that is considered as human value. Like that, every time we can discuss each and every incident, whatever they happening, that what human value is. So here, first we have to assign certain values that is considered under human values. So in this fashion, we can definitely fix out what human values are, how they are different from other animals. Okay, now regarding other animals, means other than man, various things are there for them. For example, they can't store food, with fewer exceptions like ants, rodents like a rat, and honeybees. Like that, various pure animals are there. They are there to store the food. But other than that, many animals, they are not storing out the food. And for that purpose, in their life, they are facing with shortage of food. For example, polar bear. They are the, actually we can say that Gandhism with respect to fasting is more followed by this polar bear. Sometimes they can fast for months also. So that is the thing available for polar bear. But that is not for other animals. But obviously various animals, they will not get food immediately on the requirement. Whereas in case of human being, many people in the world, I'm not saying all people in the world, but many people in the world, they are getting food more than the requirement. If you are going through developed countries, you'll find that scarcity of food is not there. Abundantly available, no doubt. It is because they carried out lots of efforts. It is also fact. Their efforts are also important. When we are talking some country is poor, then obviously we have to think why that particular country is poor. Maybe possible lack of natural resources, then maybe possible natural resources are there, but they are not used properly, so sort of mismanagement. Maybe possible other nation must have exploited them. Many times this happens, that other nations have exploited these nations, and therefore they are now poor. At some time, people don't want to work at all. They want that all luxuries should be there, but they don't want to work for that luxuries. And then onwards also, these things happen, that country is getting categorized under poor. So many countries or in world, there are some peoples, those who are not getting food, but those who are getting it twice, thrice or n number of time per day, according to requirements, for them, the things are something different. So basic difference between man and other animal is that in case of man, man is not going in search of food, whereas other animals are going in search of food with fewer exceptions. Now, other animals can't control their emotions. They are tend to react according to the situation. That all things are there lies in their brain. If you check brain of mammals other than man, then human brain is big in size. But other animals, they are not having that bigger brain, particularly cerebral hemispheres. In case of man, they are so large that they are covering out olfactory lobes. Whereas other animals, they have olfactory lobes separate and cerebral hemispheres. And that's why we have very good thinking capacity, whereas other animals are not having. And therefore, we have to assign humanity values, which are actually animal values plus than that. So animal values are there. Say for example, tiger requires food, man also requires food. Tiger will become man-eater if ordinary food is not available for tiger, or because of injury or getting older that is not able to hunt, then in search of soft prey or easy prey, they try to hunt the man, and then they have this soft food available. Now similarly, in case of man, if food is not available, then in search of food, man can do anything. So this shows we are in connection with animals. We are saying this is animal instinct, they are present. Say for example, we want water. So there we are showing our animal instinct only. That yes, to maintain our body, these things are necessary. But how to obtain, that is different way. And then we are talking about human values. Okay, so like that, first we have to list what you are considering as human values. and then how many values we are going to fulfill. Now, with the help of WhatsApp, you are trying to give expressions. Very nice smileys are there. You can check out the variety of expressions can be given in smileys. They are actually our facial expressions. So it is not only that we are able to express fewer things. That is the way we are having emotions. That is the most important thing, that human values are there. Community wise, yes, dogs are also having their own community. Horde of lions, they are having their community, but it is not as big as we are considering. This is India. So all Indians are my brothers and sisters. Say, I am staying in Mumbai. A person who is living in Arunachal Pradesh, that is other end of India, but I consider this is India only. This is my territory. The person in Arunachal Pradesh is also my brother and sister, I can consider. A person who is staying at Kanyakumari, that is also my brother and sister. Person is staying, no doubt, today they are not our regional part, but a person is staying in Gilgit or Baltistan, that is the north part of Kashmir. Today I can say at the most Nubra Valley. So person staying in Nubra Valley of Kashmir, that is my brother and sister. And technically speaking, if person is staying in Gilgit and Baltistan, that is in POK, then also my brother and sister. So like that, we are considering this is a huge community. Whereas worldwide, we are considering world as a global village. This type of thinking. And what is there? Other animals, their living instinct are different. We are getting enough food, our various emotions are there, they are satisfied, that's all. But we are thinking beyond that. We are thinking, for example, why we are here on earth. We are able to get a reasoning power. Usually other animals are not that developed reasoning power. They have reasoning power, but very short. But if you think, in case of man, we are able to get reasons of various things. And that's why we are able to think why we are living here on earth. What is the purpose of my life? What will be after my life? Then is there any connection that some abstract ideas, that is like soul, God, and all these things, concepts start coming in our mind. These all are coming under human values. This is tremendous thinking ability. That is most important thing that is coming under human value. And then we have to define the human values first. So like that, these are the human values. Now our essay is very clear for you. I am revising that values are not humanity is, but that humanity is what that values ought to be. These values are there in us, therefore we are calling it as humanity. So we can discuss in this way. And most important principle, we can go very simply, we can conclude this part of essay in this way, that if you are talking about humanity values, then the best humanity value we can justify, which is my humanity value. So I am getting pleasure, first important thing, obviously. According to Charvaka ideology, it is necessary that as long as you are living, you have to get joy of the life. Materialistic view, but yes. But another part is that with my pleasure, if anybody is getting harmed, that is we are pointing out to be the most important human value. If I am getting pleasure, say for example, I am going on a hill, on hilltop, I'm going at some pinnacle, top of pinnacle, and then I'm picking up a throne and throwing. Yes, that is the pleasure I'm getting. But I have to consider what I'm throwing out that throne, that stone, after that, where it is going to fall. Maybe possible on some human being, maybe possible on some animal, or maybe possible it may hit another stone, which will throw more stones. and more things can be injured. So is it necessary that for my joy, somebody else is getting harmed? Many people, they are considering that yes, consumption of liquor is ultimate joy in the world. But when they consume liquor, after that, if they are keeping quiet, getting home and keeping quiet, then it's all right. But many times they start because they lost their thinking ability, and then they, what they behave, actually they don't know at that time, but they are behaving, that is a torture. That is problematic for other people, other animals also many times. And then, is it reality that for my pleasure I should torture or I should harm anybody else? We have to think this way. And if you are making harm to others for your pleasure, say for your existence is something different, otherwise you should not eat any food at all, because you are aware that even plants are having emotions. According to our great Indian scientist Jagdish Chandra Bose, he only explained that how emotions are there to plant with help of chrysograph, a fantastic instrument designed by chrysograph. He showed that even minor emotions are taken by that chrysograph and mounted it million times, and therefore we are able to know that plants are also having emotion. Another great botanist named as Luther Burbank, he was able to create thornless cactus with this emotional part only. So it is not possible, but for your survival, whatever is the thing we have to do, that is again we can say our animal instinct, that we have to do. But apart from that, for your pleasure to torture anybody, that is not coming under human value. So we can give this type of idea in mind, that for my pleasure, I must get pleasure, that is my role, but for my pleasure, should I harm anybody? And then, that is, we can say, the best human value you can define. Now put this principle and find out any case. Say for example, and try to justify according to that whether it is act of humanity or not. Any case you can take, for example, a person is consuming liquor. As long as he is not torturing other people, we should say yes, he is enjoying. No doubt he is torturing himself. He is going to weaken out his liquor, liver. That is true. But he is not harming anybody else. Otherwise, you can also tell that with liquor, a person is losing out its sense of tension for some time. But by increasing tension, person can have diseases like diabetes or heart attack like that. So liquor is good or bad, that is different question, debatable topic. But here the concept is that a person, as long as not giving trouble to other people, then it is not, we have to consider as inhuman. But inhuman behavior is like that. Say for example, you check about the Nazi concentration camps. That we can say definitely inhuman behavior, obviously by Hitler. But same way, if you are saying that Genghis Khan, he was also carrying out this type of violence for satisfying his own goal. Hitler was also carrying out same thing. Under name of national requirement, he tried to satisfy his own goal. Then that is not human value. But if you are applying that principle to Hitler, that principle to Genghis Khan, then similar principle we can apply to Alexander, why I should say the great Dane. The thing is that if you are talking of Alexander, then Alexander was also not showing humanity values. Try to read history of Alexander, how he tortured people, what happened particularly in India after Alexander conquered Paurus, that battle of Hydaspes was won, and after that how he entered in Indus Valley and how he tortured people, then we will realize that his behavior is as good or bad as Hitler's behavior, as Genghis Khan's behavior. And even if you are talking of British rule in India, then also same things are there. They achieved, they performed some good things. Say for example, today what dress I am using, that is, or what language I am using, and the technology we are using, that is a good sign from Britishers or British Empire. It's good sign of British imperialism. But apart from that, they destroyed our culture. They killed so many people. Otherwise, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev, they should not hand out. Many debatable questions are there. 1857 revolt. How many peoples were killed? Without, I say, warriors are there, those armed forces, they are rebelling. If Britishers killed, I will say there, yes, Darwin's law is applicable, survival of the fittest. But then, they killed many villages. An entire village was hanged out. Like that, things were carried out in India. And then, this is not good sign. So, for satisfying one's requirement, you are torturing, you are exploiting, you are destroying others. That is not human value. So try to justify first human value and then put that, okay, these values we are considering as human value. Behaving with human values means behaving with these values. Okay, so like that you can make conclusion of this essay. Try to write down what I am speaking, again, same thing everywhere, that I am giving you only entry in the subject. You have to elaborate with this type of example. Variety of other examples may be there in your mind. You can implement whichever the correct to the topic and try to write down this essay. Thanks.